हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। दिस इज माय फिफ्थ वीडियो ऑन रेफ्रिजरेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग। टिल नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड बेसिक्स ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन साइकिल्स, देन रिफर प्लांट लाइन डायग्राम विच इज देयर ऑन बोर्ड शिप, एंड द ऑपरेशन ऑफ द प्लांट एंड द डिफ्रॉस्ट साइकिल, एंड फाइनली इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन द रेफ्रिजरेंट चार्जिंग प्रोसीजर। फ्रेंड्स, आई जस्ट मेक वीडियो which is just 5 to 10 minutes long, so try to watch full video and do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends to keep learning. In this video we'll see the line diagram of air conditioning plant which is there on board ship. So let's begin with this video. So this is the plant line diagram which is there on board ship. Previously we have already seen the line diagram for refrigeration plant, and this is the plant for air conditioning plant. So let's begin. So this is the suction, this is a suction line, plant suction line, and it passes through the condenser, the bottom part of the condenser, and then enters the compressor suction, and from this is the compressor. Then compressor discharge enters the condenser. This is the condenser, and these are the cooling water lines. These are the cooling water lines. So over here we don't have external subcooling heat exchanger. Instead, the condenser itself is designed in such a way that it acts as subcooling by taking this suction line from inside this condenser. So after this refrigerant is passed through condenser, then it is sent back to the evaporator. So this is the line which is going to the evaporator. So while passing through the evaporator, it passes through the filter and the dryer, which is this one, and the side glass. In the same location we have liquid charging wall, as we have seen in the refrigeration plant line diagram. Now after it has passed to the evaporator lines, actually it gets divided into two parts. One section goes to the small evaporator, which is for galley, only galley purpose, and other is for the accommodation. So this is actually air handling unit. In air handling unit we have cooler, which is called evaporator. So in this the expansion wall is electronically controlled. This is the expansion wall. It gets signal from the temperature sensor and the pressure sensor at the outlet of the evaporator. From the outlet of the evaporator, these are the sensors which are installed. So after this it passes again back to the compressor suction, passing through the condenser bottom part and then into the compressor suction. And similarly from this galley evaporator it enters, then again it goes back and joins the same line which is coming from the accommodation evaporator. So this is how the line diagram works in the refrigeration plant. Actually, let's see in detail this part first and then the evaporator part, this part. Now let's see each part separately. So this is the compressor diagram, or some compressor plant which is there. So this compressor has a low pressure transmitter, high pressure transmitter, and then oil pressure transmitter. This is lube oil pressure transmitter. There is oil separator, but it is not shown in this diagram. So this is the charging connection, oil charging connection for the compressor, and these solenoid valves are for the loading and unloading of the compressor depending upon the load in the cooling load on the system. So these valves are operated to unload or load the compressor. other thing is this is a condenser. It has a purging cock, and a safety valve is also installed on the condenser, which is going out into the atmosphere. Then after that, that's all we can see in this diagram. Now let's go on to the next diagram, which is the evaporator diagram. So this is the evaporator diagram. Over here we have cooler number one. Actually there are two coolers in this diagram. I've just shown one, and the expansion wall. This expansion wall actually is electronically controlled expansion wall. So it takes signal from the pressure transmitter and temperature transmitter, which are installed at the outlet of the evaporator, and they sends signal to the controller, and from the controller send signal to the expansion wall, which is controlled by this expansion wall, which is controlled by stepper motor. So accordingly, the stepper motor adjusts its position and allows the refrigerant to pass into the evaporator and controls the temperature. Then we have this solenoid wall. This solenoid wall is again operated by the thermostat, which is placed in the evaporator coil. So when temperature is reached, this solenoid wall gets shut, and this shutting of the solenoid wall will lead to low pressure activation of the compressor, and the system will be stopped. So we also have manual valve to isolate and do the maintenance on this cooler. Now let's go back onto the first diagram. I forgot to tell one more important thing. So this plant, actually there are two plants. If I draw a line straight, then we can see there are two plants. These two plants, this is plant number one, this is plant number two. So these two plants can be isolated and run separately, because for number one plant we have one cooler, okay, and for number two plant we have cooler number two, similarly for the galley. But if we want, we can run number one plant, this plant, number one plant, for number one and number two cooler both, by operating these two walls. These are the two isolating walls which are provided to run this plant by using both the coils of the evaporator of the air handling unit. Secondly, similarly, this number two plant, can be run to provide cooling in both the coolers, number one cooler and number two cooler, by operating these two walls, by isolating number one plant. So this is how by using each plant can be run separately by using their own cooler, or they can be run to operate in both the coolers, to provide refrigerant on both the coolers for cooling purpose. Other thing is, these two plants, as they can be isolated by using these two walls, they can be run parallelly for longer duration, because they can be fully isolated and can be run in parallel operation. So this is the full explanation of the line diagram which is there on board ship. Now in the next video, I'll try to cover the air handling unit which is there on board ship, in which both the cooler 1 and cooler 2 is placed, as we have seen the line diagram. So till then, keep watching and subscribe to my channel. Take care, have fun.